Hi guys, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. Here is a new playlist about using Kotlin coroutines in your Android project. In this playlist, we will learn simplifying our asynchronous codes using coroutines. But before getting started, I would like to tell you that please click on that subscribe button and the notification bell icon if you are new here. Now let's start with the very first question, that is, what is coroutine? It is basically a feature in Kotlin that helps us writing asynchronous codes in a very simplified and readable manner. It makes writing asynchronous code simpler than ever. You might already know that how difficult it is to manage and write asynchronous codes. But once you will start using coroutines, you will say wow. But before going to coroutines, let's see the problem with asynchronous codes in Android. Assume we have a function that fetches data from an API and displays on the UI. So you may write something like this. Here, network request is a blocking function, as it will perform a network request that takes time. So what will happen here? Your application will crash, because currently the code is synchronously written in the main thread, and Android does not allow us to write network operations in main thread, because it blocks the UI and leads to non-responsive applications. To solve this problem, we may use an async task that is used to asynchronously run a block of code. Here you can see we have two functions, do in background and on post execute. Inside do in background, we perform the network operation, and inside on post execute, we update the UI. The solution is complicated, but it works. Another example is when you are using Retrofit for network calls. Retrofit wraps the network operation in a call instance, and then we call the NQ function to perform the network request. Here we have two functions, onResponse to process the response, and we have a function onFailure to handle the errors. On both solutions, we are using callbacks that you can see is a little long and complicated, but still it works, and it is an okay solution for many use cases. The big problem happens when we have to make multiple requests. So assume you are using Retrofit and you want to perform 3 requests sequentially. Then what you will do, you will execute another request inside the callback of the request. As you can see here, we are executing call 2 inside the callback on response of call 1. And the same thing we are doing with call 3. And as you can see, this is something we call as callback hell. We have only 3 requests, but still the code is too much complicated and ugly. And this is what we are going to learn in this playlist. We will solve this problem using coroutines and will learn a lot more things about Kotlin coroutines. So let's see the first solution with coroutines. It is same as before, we just added a new modifier suspend to our function fetch data from network. And suspend basically means this function needs a coroutine to execute. So we cannot call a suspending function directly. We need a coroutine to call a suspend function. Here you can consider coroutine as a separate thread. Now the code seems synchronous and we may think that it will block our main thread, but it won't. Suspend means the function can suspend and start. It is same as writing callbacks, but in a simple and cleaner way. In this function, network request will be called asynchronously in the IO thread, and we will get the result and process it in the main thread. So here the update UI is our callback. It looks synchronous, but it is actually asynchronous. You are confused, right? Don't worry, from the next video, we will start practical implementation in our Android project and will learn each thing in detail. So if you like the video, then please click on that like button. That is a great motivation for me to make videos quickly. If you want to support me, then please share this channel with your friends and bring some new subscribers. In case you have a question, comment it below. So that is all for this video, friends. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.